What is up, people? So welcome to another episode of the vlog. Today I will be taking you through the editing process which I usually follow to edit all my photos. I primarily use Adobe Lightroom to edit my photos, and occasionally I go to Photoshop. Photoshop occasionally because I am not a big fan of photo manipulation. Not that I haven't done it before, I have changed the whole sky and the background. But yeah, occasionally. Without any further delay, let's jump into the computer and see how I edit my photos. Not like literally jump into the computer. You know what I'm saying. So I have already imported my photos into Lightroom. The two photos which we are going to edit today are these two. The first one is right here, which is captured using my 600D, the one I'm using to vlog right now. And the second one is captured using my Mavic Mini. So the first things I want to talk about is the format of these photos. So as you can see, this photo was captured in a .cr2 format, which is a RAW format used by Canon. As photographers, we should shoot in RAW because it gives us more leeway and more options when you are editing your photos in post-production. And the second one right here is captured using my Mavic Mini, which is a JPEG format, as you can see right here. It won't give us that many options when as a RAW format would give, but yeah, we'll work around. So the first photo right here, the first thing which I do while editing my photos is I go right down to lens corrections and enable chromatic aberrations and profile correction. The second thing which I do is bring the exposure a tad bit or reduce it according to the photo. In this, I would bring it up to bring it near to what I'm expecting the final product to be. I think that's good. Then I go to all the other sliders which are present here, like highlights, shadows, whites and blacks. Contrast I usually go to once I am done with all these sliders. Once I am done with these sliders, I increase the contrast a little bit. Not much. Yeah, this works. Next thing which I go to is the curves. I just create a simple S-curve. I take the highlights a tad bit up and reduce the shadows a little bit. So as you can see, the photo already has that rich contrast which I am looking for in a photo. But you can see it's a little dark. That we will fix it in a second. The next place which I go are these three sliders. Usually these two, texture not that much. Clarity and dehaze are my go-to sliders next. So I increase the clarity a little bit. So as you can see, as we increase the clarity, the details start coming out, but it also starts sucking out the saturation from the image. That we will fix when we go to the color section. And the next thing is the dehaze tab. So the dehaze tab brings down the exposure a little bit. So the thing with these two tabs are, there are many different thoughts on these two sliders, the clarity and the dehaze. Some people, or actually most people, are of the thought that you should not go beyond 10 with these sliders. But personally, I have gone crazy with them. But I won't go that far in this photo because it's already a little underexposed and already it has the details which I'm looking for. So I think I'm happy with these two sliders here. So the next thing which I do is, all this has made this photo a little bit yellow, which is warm. So I want to reduce it a tad bit. I go to the temperature tab. I reduce the temperature a little bit so that I can get closer to the skin color I'm trying to achieve. In a photo like this, I want to, or not just this photo, in my photos, I want to draw the viewer's attention to the subject which I'm trying to focus on. Right now in this photo, my subject is my face. Narcissist. Just kidding. So I want the viewer's attention to go to my face directly. For that, I will be using this radial filter. Radial filter usually affects the area which is inside that circle, which you will see in a bit. I draw this circle, I put it over my face. If you want to see what area is covered by the filter, the radial filter or any filter or effect which we are using in Lightroom, you simply press O and you will see which area. The area shaded in red is the area covered by the filter or any of the effect you are using. So right now, as you can see, the area covered is outside the circle, but I want the filter to affect my face, which is typically inside the circle. So I just scroll down a bit and I invert the mask. And now you can see the area covered by the radial filter is on my face. If you want to hide the this red thing, which is an indicator of the area, you just simply press O again. And so we want to adjust the exposure. I want to increase it a bit. So you can go to this drop down menu right here, select exposure. But as you can see, it looks very, very unnatural right now. We adjust these sliders present under the exposure menu. We reduce the overall exposure a little bit right there. I decrease the highlights because they are looking very unnatural right now. I decrease the shadow, decrease the shadows. I increase the whites a tad bit. And I decrease the blacks. So I think I'm happy with the exposure on my face right now. The contrast a tad bit. And the exposure also a little bit. Yeah. I guess this works for now. Still, I want some more attention on my face so that it stands out in the photo. So for this, instead of increasing the exposure on my face, we would just decrease everything else in the photo, the exposure of everything else apart from my face in the photo. So for that, I will be going to the brush tool. I would select burn, which was already selected. I would select the burn tab, the burn effect, which usually decreases the exposure on wherever the brush is applied. We just paint over the photo except my face, because we don't want that to darken again. It will just be redundancy, will beat the purpose of using the radial filter. I talk too much. So we apply the brush, fully covered, and we add another brush. So there are two schools of thought again. Some people like to work on a single brush. They apply the brush and then they adjust all the sliders here. Personally, I trust Lightroom with all the settings of sliders, and instead of working on those sliders, I just keep on adding different brushes to the photo. So this will be my second brush, and here we go. So as you can see, the focus is automatically coming on my face because we are darkening everything else apart from my face in the photo. I think I will go with another brush so that I make it a little bit more evident. After the third brush, the photo became a little more dark than I wanted it to be. So we just adjust the slider a little bit of the third brush which we have applied. I think I'm happy right there. So yeah, this is the place where I'm happy with the exposure of the photo. But still, my face is looking a little too bright and a little too unnatural. So we go to the basic sliders again. I reduce the whites a little bit more. And the highlights a bit more. Yeah, that's the place I'm happy with the exposure with my photo. So the next thing which we will be affecting are the colors. So there are two different approaches which you can follow to color correct the photo. First, there's the HSL tab, where every color is placed with the hue, saturation and luminance slider. And then these are the same sliders, but you can choose from individual colors. So for example, we have the red here, orange here, yellow, etc. You get the point. I personally use the color slider so that I can adjust every individual color as I want. The first thing which I want to adjust is my skin tone, which is looking a little dull. For that, as you know, the major color in the skin tones is orange. So the first color we will be adjusting is orange. increase the exposure a tad bit. So as you can see, as I move the slider, oh, that was scary. So I increase the exposure a little bit. I increase the luminance because I want the skin to be a little brighter. I think that works. And I move the hue a little towards the red side. I think I'm happy there. I think the exposure is a little too bright. Sorry, the saturation is a little too extra. So I decrease it a bit. Yeah. And the luminance also a bit. So yeah, I think I'm happy with the color of my skin right now. I think I'll be adding a little bit of red so that it has that rich feel towards the orange slider. Yeah. Now to add that extra effect, I would go to the curves and I would add a little bit of fade to the photo. There you go. Oh, too much. Yeah. So this is somewhere I'm majorly happy with my photo, but still my skin looks a little too white and unnatural. So I'd go to the exposure and decrease it a tad bit. Yeah, this is a place where I'm happy with my photo. Now we move on to the second photo, which is a JPEG clip from my mini. So I follow the same process here also. I go to chromatic aberrations, lens correction, profile correction. So as you can see, it did not change anything in this photo because Lightroom does not know the make and the model, or yet they haven't included the DJIs or the drones in their profile correction list, I guess. That's what you say. So as you can see, even when I enabled these options, it did not change anything in the photo. So for this photo, I would like to take the exposure a little bit down because I want to enhance the colors. And one thing with colors is lesser the exposure, more colors would pop out. So then I go to the highlights a little bit. Again, I'm going for that high contrast look for this photo also. I think I'm happy with these sliders. Little bit of contrast. Then I won't touch the temperature tab because I'm happy with the temperature of this photo as of yet. Then I go to the curves. Again, a simple S curve. There you go. And there you go. So as you can see, already because of the high contrast nature of this photo, the colors are popping out. But I want them to pop out even more so that you can get that separation in both these colors, the greens and the mud color. Mud color? Yeah, the color of the mud right here. Next, again, we go to the clarity. That bit. Because, so in this photo, I will go a little crazy with the clarity because I want those details to pop out with the colors. Same with the dehaze. So the major colors available right now, or the major colors which we want to adjust, are greens and the orange color. The first color is green. I would increase the saturation. So as you can see, the colors have started to pop out. I would decrease the luminance a bit because of the thing I just told you. Lesser the exposure, more the color. But I'm not so happy with the hue of this color, so I would move the slider a little bit towards the right. I like a little bit of cooler green. I think I'm happy with the green here. Next color we move to is orange. So I increase the saturation. So as you can see, we are getting that good separation color wise in the photo. And I decrease the luminance. And I move it a little bit towards the orange side, reddish orange side. I think I'm happy with the color and the exposure here. I think I'll take the exposure down a tad bit. Just a bit. Yeah. But one thing which is bothering me about this photo is the angle of the photo. It's a little bit off axis towards the left. So to correct that, we go to the crop menu, crop overlay, which you can see the dotted square right here. We click it and we go. There are two ways you can adjust the angle. First, you can move the slider, which I usually don't use. I just go below the photo till you get that V arrow shape and you adjust the angle. So when I'm adjusting the angle of a photo, I look for straight lines which usually appear straight in the real world. For example, I look at door frames, window frames to make that photo straight, because never trust your eyes. For this photo, I'll be using this path going right. It's not fully straight, but major part of the path is straight, so I can use it to correct the angle. I think I'm happy there with the photo. Another thing which is bothering me about this photo is the perspective of the photo. I know it's taken top down, but it looks like it's not completely 90 degree, though it is. But because of these elements in the photo, it's giving a feel that it's not exactly 90. There's a way to correct that also in Lightroom. You go to the transform menu. Where is it? Yeah. So you get all these vertical, horizontal, rotate aspect, scale, etc. For this, we'll be adjusting the vertical axis of the photo. As you can see, as I adjust the vertical axis, I think it's a bit too much. Yeah. So now you can see that it's looking that it was taken from an exactly 90 degree angle. But one problem which this adjustment has posed is these white blank areas right here. But that's not a problem for me in this photo, because I was going to crop it anyway a little bit, because I don't want these distractions right here at the edge of the photo. One thing which I am trying to achieve in this photo, or I am trying to maintain is this, in this photo, is that I keep this track right in the center, so it can create that natural symmetry on both sides of the track. And here we go. So that is my final edit for this photo. I think I can move the greens. I can increase the greens so that it pops out a little more. Saturation a bit, luminance. And the same goes for the orange also. Yeah, right there I'm happy with my photo. So yeah, that was it from my side in this video. I hope you liked the video and you gained something from the process which I follow in Lightroom. If you like the video, like, share and subscribe to the channel. And if you want any specific video or you want me to make a video on a particular topic, do let me know in the comments. Also let me know about your feedback, what you feel about my videos in the comments below. So yeah, that's it from my side in this video. See you later. Nah, this is too long.